I'm a hypochondriac, but not... I don't invent things. It's just that when something happens, I think it's worse than it is, right? I had an incident with my doctor 6 months ago where she told me I couldn't come back for a year, even if I really was dying, because I had such a hypochondriacal episode and made such an ass of myself. Now, I want to tell you this story, but it's going to be filmed, and now a cliche is going to be stuck on me, because the story also involves my period. And people have a problem when women talk about their periods. People. Men. So, the common wisdom that people say is women aren't funny. Okay, great. I can't do anything about that. If you don't think I'm funny, check out other women, right? Women is not a type of comedy. Women is a type of person. I think women are people. I'm not sure. Anyway, but let's take apart why it's so difficult to talk about a period. I think sometimes people just don't know what a period is. And so a man doesn't want to hear about it because he's like, I kind of feel stupid. I don't really know what it is. And that's no problem. They didn't explain it to us either. When I turned 11, my mother was like, you're going to get your period. I'm like, what's that? She's like, a thing you're going to get. When am I going to get it? Anytime between now and the next 7 years. Oh, my God. And then you're just walking to school like, going to get my period, going to get my period. What's my period? I think it comes out of here. Shit, do I have my period? Can anyone see? And so it's... So here's what a period is. So let's just start with education, and then we'll get to the fun, funny story about a hypochondria in my period, right? Here we go. Now, in case anyone doesn't know what a period is, every month a woman sheds the interior of her uterine lining because she's not pregnant, because she's a dirty, dirty whore who didn't do the one thing God put her on earth to do, which is make a baby, and that's her 3 to 5 day punishment. So, that's what a period is. Now, I think men can handle that fact, right? And I'm not making fun of men. I mean, the thing, men aren't ever mean to us about our periods when we talk about them, or they're never mean to us. It's just they don't want to hear it. And I understand that because the world caters to you and you don't have to hear about anything that you don't know about. And that must be really scary when you have to, so we must be kind to men. I don't like the old hacky thing of, well, men had their periods, they'd be like, yeah, blood everywhere, we're gonna name a bar after it, yeah, you know. Hey, maybe that would be true, maybe it wouldn't, but I don't know if it would be true, because if men were the ones getting their periods, then women would be the ones not getting their periods. And so it would be unequal. And I know what I'm like when I don't understand things in a man's body, you know what I mean? I'm like, oh, why do you have to have balls? They're like, because I have them. Just get rid of it. Like, I'm not necessarily nice. And so I wonder what I would be like if I had a boyfriend who got his period, because men get the periods and I've never had one. And if I'm at dinner, my boyfriend comes out of the bathroom and he's like, Jen, we gotta go. Jonathan, we didn't even order an appetizer yet. Jen, I just got my period a day early. And I'm wearing white pants. We gotta go. Oh, what do you mean you got your period a day early? Doesn't it come on the same day every month? No, Jen, it's a whole hormonal thing. It's irregular. I can't control it. Oh, I can't control my body. Oh, it's hormones made me do it. Come on, you can control it. Jen, I can't. Well, did they have tampons in the bathroom? No, they're out. And I said, so we gotta go. Do you have a tampon in your purse, Jonathan? No, I forgot. Jonathan, how many times have I told you, be a fucking man and keep a tampon in your purse in case you get your period early? And why would you wear white pants anywhere near the week of your expected period? God, what? How long have you been getting this? 20 years now? Why can't you do this, Jonathan? You can leave. I'm eating here. We've had this reservation for 2 weeks. You can leave. I'm staying. Go. Tie your jacket around your waist, Jonathan. Everyone can see your period. Then I call my friend. I'm at a restaurant alone. Yeah, but Jonathan got his period. No, of course he didn't. He didn't know it was coming. No, he never knows. Oh yeah, like Jonathan had a tampon in his purse. Are you crazy? We're talking about Jonathan here. I don't know if I can be with him, because just like if he can't plan for himself, then like, how could he plan for me, you know? So that might be what women are like if men got their periods. Here's what happened to me. Now my period comes on the same day every month. It has never been early. It has never been late. I don't get cramps. Thank you. So, One morning, when I was 41 and a half years old and really feeling it, just thinking about it, God, almost 50. I mean, not really, but closer than I was when I was 13, right? I woke up in the morning and I went to the ladies' room. There's not a ladies' room in my house. It's not like, ladies, men, wheelchair, you know. I was going pee. And I looked in my underwear and there were some fresh drops of blood. Now again, it was 2 weeks from when I was supposed to get my period. And this was not uterine lining looking blood. This was prick your finger fresh blood. It actually looked like the blood that my roommate's cat had years and years ago. And I was just a young thing with a roommate in Brooklyn and she had a dying cat. And the cat dragged its body across the floor as little drops of blood came out because the cat's kidneys were failing. That's right. And my roommate had to put the cat in a cage and the cat got put down that day, the same day that the blood drops appeared in the morning. And I looked at myself and I went, today is the day I will be put down. I don't have a human-sized cage and I live alone. I knew if I didn't start a family, this would happen, but I will have to put myself down. I will call the vet and I will make an appointment. Because I knew that's internal bleeding. My kidneys are failing, I have internal bleeding. But before I freaked out, I checked my vagina for glass. And so I just wanted to make sure. Because I take sleeping pills sometimes and you can sleepwalk on those. So I just wanted to make sure that in the middle of the night, I didn't start sleepwalking and then get into a bar fight and break a bottle and then put it in me and go, come on, come at me. So I called a couple friends. I'm like, did I get in a bar fight with my vagina last night? And they're like, I don't think so. And I was like, okay, cool, thanks. Oh, the bad news is then, I must be put down today. I don't make a fuss, it's internal bleeding. I'm gonna call my doctor. So I call my doctor, I said, I have to come in, I have internal bleeding. And I get there and she puts me in the stirrups, which is so stupid, because I'm like, this isn't a period thing. Do an X-ray, I have internal bleeding. My kidneys are failing rapidly, come on. And she just looks up and goes, Jen, this is your period. I go, no, it isn't. And she goes, yes, it is. I go, it's not supposed to be here for 2 weeks. She goes, well, it's 2 weeks early. I go, well, I want a second opinion. She goes, what do you want a second opinion about? I said, I still think this is internal bleeding. And she said, it's not. And I said, how do you know? And she said, because you're seeing the blood externally. Oh, that's such a fucking amazing point. I never thought about that. That's why people die from internal bleeding, you guys, because they don't see the blood. Okay, I got it. Good, all right, I am stupid. She just looked at me and she went, are you okay? And I went, I don't think so, no, I don't. And like a child being handed a toothbrush by a dentist, she just handed me a tampon and was like, get out of here. And now the worst part is I have a subscription for tampons on Amazon. And I keep forgetting to cancel it. And so every month I get so many tampons and I have a closet filled with them. They will outlive me. I will be in menopause before them. I will be dead. I will just one day be in a chair, no blood left in my body. Like, I haven't even seen blood on a tooth, let alone this. And I have no kids, so I have no one to give them to. So I'm the weird lady at Halloween every year where it's like, ding dong, trick or treat. And I'm like, you'll be a woman someday. Yes, take this. Even you, little boy, you never know. Take it, take it, take it, everybody.